The time value of money is an important concept to understand. Investors can use the time value of money to calculate the fair value of a company, and people trying to save money can use it to calculate how long it will take or how much they would need to put aside each week, month, or year to achieve their financial goal. The best news is the concept is actually quite simple. So we're going to walk through two examples. The first will examine a family that wants to save for a house. The second will act as an investor who wants to value a business. So at the core of the time value of money concept is that a dollar today is not worth the same amount as a dollar next year. To illustrate this point, imagine I came to you and said, I'm going to give you $1,000. And I pause. During that pause, you start asking yourself, what could I buy with that $1,000? What would I use it for? And then, after my unnecessarily long drama-building pause, I finish that sentence by saying, in 10 years. Well, that changes everything. I have no idea what I would do with it in 10 years, but I knew what I would do with it now. I was going to save for a house. Now, the time value of money matters more than just knowing what you're going to do with it or not. In fact, $1,000 today is actually worth more than $1,000 in 10 years. Much of the difference in value revolves around what is known as opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is the value of different opportunities that were forfeited by not having that cash today. So let's see how this works. We're saving for a house. For now, you have $1,000 to start saving. We want to save for 10 years. How much will we have in 10 years? Let's look closer. So here we are today. We have our $1,000. What will it be worth next year? Well, that depends on what you do with it. If you put it in a savings account that pays 2% per year, well, that $1,000 is worth $1,020 next year. Not bad. But what if we found two other investment opportunities? One would pay us 5% and the other would pay us 10%. Well, the 5% is worth $1,050 next year and the 10% is worth $1,100. I bring this out to illustrate how important the return you get on your initial investment is and to illustrate opportunity cost. So let's stick with the 5% return from here and keep it simple. And if we stopped right here at this point, well, you could probably see that the $1,000 today is actually worth $50 more than $1,000 in 1 year. In this example, that is the opportunity cost. If I had offered you $1,000 today or $1,050 next year, which would you choose? Well, if you knew you had a chance to invest the $1,000 today and get a 5% return, well, it wouldn't have mattered which one you took. Now, if I offered you $1,060 next year, well, you should take that. Your potential return is just 5% with today's money, and I just offered you the equivalent of 6%. Assuming you believe me, waiting a year makes the most sense. So now let's do the math, which is actually quite simple. So if we continue our example, to get our $1,000 into the future, we simply need to increase that amount by our expected return. So it's $1,000 times 1 plus R. R is the return. In our case, we're expecting a 5% return. So $1,000 times 1.05 equals $1,050. Now, just in case you're not super confident with this type of math, you add 1 to your expected return because 1 represents 100% of your initial number. You might have done this exact math in a restaurant if you wanted to leave a tip. You take the final bill of, let's say, $100 and multiply it by the tip of, let's say, 20%, which is 1.2, and you end up with $120. Now, some people may think to themselves, okay, what is 20% of $100? Well, that's $20. Then you add that $20 to the starting bill of $100, and we get $120. Well, this is that exact same thing, just a bit shorter. So when we multiply our starting number by 1.05, or 105% of our starting value, this gives us next year's value. They call this future value. Now, we could do this quite simply for each time period. If you take the $1,050 times 1.05, we get $1,102.50. Now, it's important to recognize here that during the first year, our money grew by $50, and in the second year, it grew by $52.50. And that is what is known as compound interest, or the power of compounding. See, that $50 you earned in the first year earned $2.50 in the second year. And that will just keep happening every year. The money you earn will earn more money for you. So we could do that math for each year and keep going right down the line. And that would be easy enough. But there is another shortcut. So we know that this formula is the future value formula. And that is true as long as the future value is in one time period. Well, in our case, if we wanted to skip ahead to see what the value would be in year 10, well, the only adjustment we'd have to make to the formula is to add the number of periods right here. So if we want to know the future value in year 10, we simply add 10 here. And this future value will now be the value of our $1,000 in year 10, assuming we earn 5% a year. And in year 10, we will end up with $1,628.89. So if you had a calculator or Excel, you can easily calculate what the future value will be in 5 years or 20 years or whatever. The math stays the same. So now let's see how a potential investor can use the time value of money. Let's imagine that we're looking to buy a business. And based on our research, we are expecting that business to generate free cash flow of $10,000 next year and $13,000 the year after, then $17,000, $22,000, and $28,000 in each of the following years. Then after that, the business is going to cease to exist. So now, the question is, what are each of these future cash flows worth today? So the math is very similar to what we already know. Instead of trying to calculate the future value like we did before, now we're going to calculate the present value. Here's what that formula looks like. So all we do is we take the future value, let's use year 5 as an example. Well, we have $28,000 and we divide that by 1 plus the discount rate. And since it was year 5, we raised this to the power of 5. So let's also imagine that our discount rate is 5%. Now the discount rate we're using here is similar to the return rate we used before. Sometimes when we calculate the future value like we did before, well, they call that rate the interest rate. But when we're calculating present value, they call it the discount rate. You might also hear it called a required rate of return. So basically, if we require a return of 5%, assuming that each of our projected cash flow numbers are accurate, then the present value we calculate will be exactly what the business is worth if we want a 5% return. If we want a 10% return, well, we should use that as our discount rate, and this formula would give us what we should pay for the business to get a 10% return. So if we finish our math, here is each of the formulas, and here's what each year's cash flow is worth today. So now all we have to do is add each of these up and get the total value of the business today. And that turns out to be $76,039 at a 5% return, or to say it more accurately, using a 5% discount rate. Now, if we wanted a 10% return, the value falls to $65,019. And this number being lower makes sense. If you want to return more, well, you want to pay less today. Well, if you paid less than this $65,000, well, your return would be greater than the 10% discount rate we use to calculate the present value. Now, we did a lot of this math by hand, and I did it using Excel, which can be simple enough because, as you can see, the math is not terribly complicated once you understand the concept. But there are calculators out there that have functions that solve these exact problems. As an example, I use the Texas Instruments Business Analyst Plus calculator, and I find it to be great for this type of calculation. But at the end of the day, however you calculate it, if you understand the concept behind the time value of money, it could be very useful. You can use it to see what your investments would be worth in 5 or 10 years if you invested a certain amount of money every month. Now, one quick point. If you adjust the frequency of deposits or investments, don't forget to adjust the number of periods in your formula. So if you added money each month and you were expecting a 5% return each year, well, you have to divide that 5% by the 12 months that are in a year, and that would give you a monthly return rate of 0.4167. Now this becomes the R in the 1 plus R part of the formula. And now you raise it to the number of months. So a 5-year investment would be 60 months. So you'd raise this to the power of 60. On a calculator, they call this number of periods compounding periods. And this adjustment is true when you're calculating for either future value or present value. Now if you flip this formula around a bit, you can see what R needs to be to achieve a certain goal. So if you have $10,000 today, and you needed to grow to $20,000 in, let's say, 5 years, well, you plug that in, and then you can see that your calculation says that you need to return 14.87% a year to get to your $20,000 goal within 5 years. And those are just a few examples of how people can utilize the time value of money. If you have any questions about the world of investing, any suggestions on videos, please post in the comments below, and please subscribe as we continue to update with new videos every week. Thank you.